When did you take this picture?
Just after we came to Vancouver Island. I remember a man approached me. He seemed displeased, telling me that it was improper for a woman to be here alone. But Victoria was my new home, and I was going to be a part of it. I remember us. We had to sit still, perfectly still, for countless minutes. I couldn't look at you. It was hard to hold off the emotions. I was so happy. I love photographing you, Lily. Capturing you in my studio. The studio where nobody came.
People were afraid.
Yes, I even had to sell my photographs under Daddy's name. My own name wasn't good enough. But I still had you.
And then all the other children came.
Do you remember in the beginning, Lily, how exciting the work was? Yet how challenging the compositions. Remember, we found that all we had to do was tell them a story, and they would find their own expressive pose. And then it all happened so quickly. You fell ill.
I died.
You died. I was not ready to let you go. I turned to the camera, searching, but nothing. Then she arrived. I don't remember exactly when. Who was this woman posing before me? What did she want?
Well, what are you waiting for?
I felt numb. Here you go, Lily. Be careful now. It's still hot. What is she doing just sitting there? Oh, leave her be. She just needs more time.
I love what you've done with your hair.
They wouldn't leave. And I suspected duplicity. Why isn't she joining us?
She's afraid.
Doesn't she see we're trying to help?
She doesn't trust us yet.
What would Lily want? I decided to take a chance.
Would you like some tea?
Why, thank you. I thought you'd never ask. Would you like some cream, too? Settle down, you two. My grandson, Mayor, has come to live with me. How fragile the boundary between life and death. Once fearful, I now find myself confronting the inevitable. And through Mayor's presence, I feel closer to your spirit. Dearest Lily, I thought you had left me. You were floating away, almost unreal, when I needed you to be still. But your existence in this life is undeniable. I went to the cemetery and visited your grave and those of my other loved ones. I got a few leaves as relics. Never saw such a beautiful place in my life. The past is all that's left a token, and your memory lingers on as still. But time does not. And as it moves me forward, I can look back. And I can thank you, Lily, for all that you have taught me.